Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Gillian. If you're new here, it's nice for you to join me for a B&M haul today. I would really appreciate if you clicked subscribe down below and gave this video a thumbs up if you enjoy it. It means so much to me and I appreciate each and every one of you. So I'm not going to ramble in this video, hopefully, so we'll just get straight into the haul. I would say about half of these things I bought a couple of months ago and I just never got around to filming the B&M haul. And then recently I went again for some more festive kind of things. So it's going to be a pretty big haul. Half Christmassy, half not. So I'll just get started. The first thing you can see in the background, I'll get it just now to show you. It's this festive star light and it was £10 and it's so beautiful. I'm not sure where I will put it yet, but I saw it and I couldn't resist. It's like a distress painted white wood with deer and a little owl at the top of the tree there. I just thought it was really nice. Kind of goes with the theme that I already have. Last year my mother-in-law bought me a wooden candle from the Edinburgh Christmas market that kind of looks quite similar, so it'll match the decor once I put it up. I've not got my Christmas tree stuff up yet. I'll just quickly go through some of the non-festive items. It's more cleaning products. So first of all I got an elbow grease scrub mate and I can't remember why I got this, but it will come in handy. I think it was maybe when my oven was dirty. You can use it for glass pots and pans, things like that, so I just got one of those and it wasn't very expensive at all. The next thing I got was a dish matic. It's my favourite way, this sounds so sad that I'm saying about my favourite way to wash the dishes, but my favourite type of sponge is that kind of sponge, but I've never had it on the handle where you put the fairy liquid inside at the bottom, so I think it'll be good. I'm excited to try it and I think, yeah, it comes with a couple of spare ones as well, so it should last a fairly decent time. Another thing that was for cleaning my oven was the pink stuff. I've never used it before, but my mum's got it and she likes it, so I decided to give it a go. This is the paste version. I think there's a spray version, but it's by the brand Stardrops and I've had their like glass cleaner and stuff before. Yeah, got some of that to clean my oven. Another cleaning product I got is this. I wasn't sure if it was a cheap version of the Minky or it was an actual Minky, but yeah, it's a proper Minky and it's just in this rainbow pattern. I've never had a Minky before, but I thought it'd be quite good for cleaning the bath or the downstairs sinks and stuff like that, so I just got it to try because obviously a lot of people love using it. I got, this is one of the last cleaning products. It's just to keep your bin smelling fresh. It's in a citrus scent and I think you just chuck it in before you put the bin bag in. Oh no. Shake a dosage of 1.5 teaspoons over the contents of the bin each time you use it. I mean, I don't think my bin's that dirty, but I thought I'd stick some at the bottom of the bin and it'd keep it smelling fresh. Eliminates smells, soaks up liquid and repels flies and insects. So yeah, just thought I'd give it a try. I got an air freshener. This I can use in my car as well. It's quite good to finish cleaning it off with a bit of air freshener. And it's in the Unstoppable scent. And I love the Unstoppables in my washing, so I thought this would smell really nice. Not much more to say about that. I then got this baking tin. It's upside down. This was £3.99 and we just needed more baking tins and this is quite a deep one. So it'll be good for like roasting veggies or stuff like that, something that's a bit more substantial. I then got some Simple face wipes. These are vegan and cruelty free and I just needed something to, even when you wash your face and you think you've done a good job, sometimes the mascara still ends up under my eye, so just thought I'd use that to kind of finish cleaning it off. And these ones are, it says it's kind to skin and it removes waterproof mascara, so that's why I got it. I got these things a couple of months ago but they do still have them. So the first thing is this little Tupperware and it says it's new bone china, so it's not plastic. The lid's plastic though, but I thought it'd be good if I needed to heat anything up in the house, like for leftovers. I just liked it and it's a cute little panda, so yeah, that's why I got that. Then got two plates and mostly to switch up my Instagram game a little bit, not gonna lie. I post all the vegan food that I eat on my Instagram, so I thought it'd be good to have a bit of a different background than the usual plates that I've got. So the first one is grey and yellow with like a some kind of sun circle pattern, and it was only £2.50. And then the other one kind of matches, but it's a turquoise colour, and that's grey and turquoise as well, and I just like them. Be good for the background of my dishes, and I think that they look cute. So, and I like that they're different but they still kind of match. So yeah, I'm excited to use those in my next meals. I've got a couple of food bits here, so sorry if you can hear rustling, but the first thing I'll do is party rings. These are little individual bags. You get 6 bags, and I think it was no more than £1, I would say. I can't remember exactly, so apologies for that, but they are handy for snacking on, and as most of you will know, I'm on Slimming World, and these are like 5.5 sins, so it's good to have in the cupboard, and I have opened these ones already. The next two things are crisps. So again, I've opened and had one bag already, but it's the Ritz Baked Original Minis. Again, it comes in a 6-pack of the little 25-gram bags. I think these are 6 sins, if I'm not mistaken. I love Ritz crackers, and it's easy to eat a full box of them, so it's good that they're portioned out like this. And then I saw these crisps, and I didn't realise that they were vegan, but they are the Liam Perrin's Worcestershire Sauce Crisps by Seabrook. And I like Seabrook's Prawn Cocktail Crisps, which are vegan, so I thought I would give these a go. And they definitely are, I've double checked, and I'm interested to see what they taste like. I think they'll be quite nice. Moving on to more festive items, I got this box, which is 30 by 30 centimetres, so the size of a ruler. And I just thought it would be good for Ryan's presents to put some of them in this. And it was only £2.50, and I thought it was decent enough that we can use it next year as well, and I think it would just look nice under the tree. There was quite a few designs of that style of box, so yeah, I just saw it and liked it. I got this decoration. It's again white wood with a deer and a silver sparkly tree on it, and it lights up as well. I think this one takes AAA batteries, that one was AA, and this one was £5 for a woodland scene. I think it'll look nice in our hall windowsill. I seem to really go for a lot of the things that lit up, but the Christmas aisle was actually quite empty when I went, and that was only the 1st or 2nd of December, I think I went. It was not that long ago, and I think everybody's just panicked and bought everything, because a lot of people have put their trees up already, like even in November, so I think that they were unexpectedly sold out of a lot of stuff. So I'm quite lucky that I managed to find these things, unless they're going to do a bigger restock, I'm not sure. But this was a light up woodland scene, and it's a hanging decoration, and that was £4. Again, lights up. Oh, maybe that's got batteries in it because it's got one of the pulley out things. Yes, it does. I thought that would look nice in front of a window. It's all the same kind of theme, wood, white and deer. I just think that's really nice, and I like the little wooden beads at the top. So yeah, £4. I actually saw a lot of nice wrapping paper, but I've already got some, so I just got these bows that I knew I needed. So these were £1.50 for a pack of 15, and it also comes with a little thing of ribbon at the bottom as well. So I got a silver, shiny silver, and a glitter silver, and then I got some with green and white in it as well, because I do have some green wrapping paper, and I thought it would match nicely. They had gold as well, but none of my wrapping paper kind of match gold, so I just got these colours. I also saw these iridescent bows that were slightly bigger variety of sizes, and it was £1.50 for 24. So yeah, got those as well. I got 2 little ornaments. Like I said, B&M were pretty bare in their aisles for Christmas, because a few weeks ago I had seen it was kind of like this ornament, but it was 3 polar bears piled on top of each other, and I really wanted that one, but they didn't have it in stock when I was there. So I just got this, which was £2.99, and it's just a little bear on a sleigh, a little polar bear, and I thought that was really cute. And then I also got its little friend that's a reindeer on a sled. And there was a penguin, but I didn't really like the way it looked, so I just got these two and thought I could sit them either end of a windowsill or in my hallway or something, even in here. I just thought they were really cute, so yeah, I randomly picked this up because my mum had been talking about needing new hairspray, and this is a Tresemme Perfect Everyday Hair Kit, and it was maybe £4. It wasn't expensive at all, and it comes with shampoo, conditioner, hairspray and a little brush that looks a bit like a tangle teaser. I just thought it'd be a good little thing to add into all our presents. Nearly finished, I got a couple of drinks and the last thing I need to go downstairs for because I forgot about it, but I just got a big can of Iron Brew. It was only like 50 pence. I just fancied it. It's the extra, so it's no sugar. And then I always get a can of the Apple Monster from B&M. I usually prefer White Monster, but whenever I see the apple, I get it as like a little treat, so I got that. I just went downstairs to get this cereal that I'm going to show you, and Ryan, my fiance, was like, you can't film that. And I was like, thinking he'd maybe ate it all, but it's just because it's bent over to fit in the cupboard, but it's okay. So the last item I got at B&M were Oreos, and it smells so good. It's just like eating crushed up Oreos and milk. It's amazing. And I saw on a vegan Facebook page that they were suitable for vegans because sometimes the vitamin D in things have the oil from sheep's wool in it, so that's why vegans can't have like Cocoa Pops and stuff. Very excited to have these in my life. The first time I had a bowl, I poured too much and felt a bit sick afterwards, so yeah, they are quite sickly, but they're a good treat to have. They were very expensive. I think it was £3 or £3.99, I can't remember. More than what I would have wanted to pay for them, but I thought it was a one-off, and because they're new, I just fancied them. So that is my B&M haul, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and if there is any Christmas stuff left at B&M at this point, I hope you got your hands on it and maybe got some ideas for decorations. If you enjoyed my video, please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. It would mean a lot to me, and subscribe down below, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye.